I'm very well, thank you.
Thank you. Welcome at Budeshi Radio. I really want to apologize for not being able to come to your hearing in the past 2 or 3 weeks. We really, really apologize. It was due to logistic issues, so we really apologize. But henceforth, we'll be coming your way every Thursday, 11:30 a.m. to discuss Budeshi Radio. And Budeshi Radio is openness in governance. Openness in governance. And I have this morning, we'll be talking about citizens' engagement with public procurement data in Ekiti State. And I have with me this morning two guests, in person of Kayode Owosha. Kayode, good morning.
Good morning to you.
Welcome to Budeshi Radio. And I also have Lawrence Olowolayemo. I used to call him Pastor Richie. Good morning, sir.
Thank you. Merci pour ton
travail. Yeah, welcome to Budeshi Radio. Now, let me start us with, this program, like I used to say, is brought to you by Public and Private Development Center Abuja, and we'll be discussing citizens' engagement with public procurement data in Ekiti State. So, in recent times, subnational governments and have increasingly committed to open contracting as a transparency mechanism and to reform their procurement process. Ekiti being one of these states, what can you say are the benefits you are seeing results from open contracting in Ekiti State?
All right, thank you very much. I'm good to have you, have everybody on back to listen to us this morning. So I want to first start this way by talking about the importance of open governance. You know, I want to appreciate the leadership of the state government for first showing interest in signing up for that process. It happened to be the first state in the Southwest that signed up for open governance, which give room for openness in governance in terms of procedures and processes in governance, which reduces corruption and also enhancing transparency and accountability in governance. So it's a lot of things, it's a lot of processes, and so it comes with a lot of advantage for people to see how governance is being initiated by the leaders, and how citizens also need to see how they participate in it to ensure we achieve what we call an inclusive governance, which is for all. So open procurement, open contracting, it's that process of ensuring that the processes in governance, it's not just about giving out contract to people and ensuring the job is done. It's a whole lot of process to ensure that things are done in a proper way and ensuring that the money which belongs to the people surely work for the people. So if I'm to say it in my own time, it's the process that empowers citizens to engage their leaders.
Okay, Mr. Tesley, do you really agree to what he's saying? Because as for me, I don't really agree to that. Yes, from personal view, I don't really agree to that because I don't know, maybe there is something called open contracting in Ekiti State.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
Yes, to add to what Pastor Richie has said, open contract is just to put an end to corruption, whereby the governance is open to everybody, the community people, the stakeholders in the community. So this makes governance transparent. This makes everyone to be accountable. People can engage government. How do you spend our money? Let them understand that this money does not belong to government, it belongs to people. So people can leverage on the Freedom of Information Law, which has Freedom of Information Act, which has been enacted in the states that become in law. People can leverage on this to ask government questions. How do you spend this money? How do you do this? How do you do that? So it also helps community people to ask questions too. It also helps them to have access to information.
Okay. Now, Pastor Lawrence, I want to ask, do you think that it is actually necessary for citizens to participate in procurement process in the state?
All right, let me first correct a notion from your last conversation. You said you really don't believe
there's open contracting process in Ekiti State. So that's one of the reasons why we're coming on radio, to educate our people to understand what governance is all about and what government's really doing at their own control.
I need you to know, during the first time of check from from state to state, from local government to government, to capture that input. What do you want from this community? What do you want from this community? Then that will be captured into the budget. Then,
how will you rate the participants of citizens when it comes to this? Thank you. active participation as key stakeholders in benchmarking, especially high value contracts?
Okay, thank you very much. Like I said the other time, this first thing the people of the community need to know is to understand this process.
Okay.
That is about citizen engagement, engaging with leaders and understanding that whatever government is trying to do is not doing it for himself or for themselves rather. But rather the whatever government is doing is for the citizen. Government is actually working for the citizen. So for any contract or for any project that government wants to put in place, the citizen need to be engaged from the start. Do we even need this process or this project? Sometimes, you know, we are, this is not going to be the area where government should just come up and construct something or do something for you that might not be useful for the citizen. So okay. We need to start from having a dialogue with our leader to see, okay, these are the main important issue or project that will be useful for us at this moment. When you have that conversation, then the government should listen to the people, then work having a system that harvests such, suggestion, then ensuring that those are the things that is being done. Then when we talk about value for money, number one, it's talking about having the mind to do the right thing,
okay,
ensuring that the resources that is being approved is what is being done for, useful for what the actual project that has been assigned for.
Assigned.
So this thing will reduce wastage, it will reduce unnecessary spending or wasting of resources on things that are not really important. So better we put some of these things together, then we ensure that we are having value for money. Okay. Ensure that we're having what we call value for money, then it will bring development. There's no way we can drive inclusion or development in the community if people are not involved and they're not doing the right thing for them to ensure that this thing will work for them. So I think by this process, we will ensure that we have value for our money.
All right. Before we continue, I would like to maybe Fortune have one or two things to say.
Well, I would say that it's been an interesting one, and that's why I told you earlier from the start that you should tune in and listen, because we have experts. That's why I call them experts. They have an in-depth knowledge of the topic for today. All right, we'll be going on a break now when we return, and that will be very short. So you stick around. There is more to learn from the stable of Budeshi Radio. Stay with us.